El Shaddai World Ministries. El Shaddai World Ministries. There is grace upon this ministry to take the power of God to the nations and to tell the world that Jesus is the Christ.
Thank you. been in one before? How many will be in one? Off, there's something that they call altitude. So it must reach its maximum altitude before you even realize its maximum speed. Sometimes you find that the plane will fly, you know, when they talk, the feet, thousands of feet, and so forth. Mostly, they normally fly at about 10 kilometers off the ground. 10 km. Count kilometers going up. When it gets there, you hear the pilot saying, now we are in our space. And he will switch off the seatbelt light. You say, you can relax now. Because we are in our place. We can now cruise. And when the plane starts cruising, those that are inside have no idea how fast that thing is going. It cruises. And it picks up its maximum. You see, as a child of God, there is a higher dimension within which you can function. There is a terrain where you belong to. You could never realize your maximum speed on the ground. And you could never realize it taking off. You remember sometime last year, Control Tower cleared you for takeoff. But as you were taking off and as you were taking off, you could never realize your maximum speed taking off. There is a higher plane for you, a higher dimension within which you can cruise and fulfill every dream that you ever dreamed. Prophet Zechariah speaks. Zechariah 2, reading from verse 1 to 5. To verse 4. And I lifted up my eye and saw, and behold. King James will say, I looked again, or I lifted up mine eyes again. Which means there was a place where he lifted up his eye, saw nothing. But then he lifted his eyes again. I'm leading you somewhere today. He lifted his eyes again. And behold, a man. Look at the person next to you and say, behold, a man.
Behold, a man.
Say it again, behold, a man.
Behold, a man.
Say it again, behold, a man.
Behold, a man.
Rabo Shabakataza. Look at them again and say, behold a man.
Behold a man.
Did you see that? Yeah. We can just end it here and just enjoy ourselves. But there's so much that must be shared.
Amen.
Behold a man. What is this man doing? What is this man holding? The Bible tells us that behold a man with a measuring line. He's carrying a tape measure. And his intention is one. He is running. Praise God.
Amen.
He is running. He is with a measuring line in his hand. Then said I, where are you going?
Look at the person next to you and say,
where are you going?
I said, where are you going? And they said to me, to measure Jerusalem. See, I'm so excited. It doesn't look like I'm excited. I say to him, just play something that's not high, come on, so that I just calm down, because I will mess up this thing. It's too good. I told him, don't high, come on. You are there to just calm me, like David calmed Saul. When a demon came on him. For me, it's not a demon today. But the Holy Ghost can manifest like a demon.
Hallelujah!
Don't say that way. Where are you going? And he said to me, to measure Jerusalem. To see what is the breadth and the width of the city. What is breadth times width? Width times equal? So he says, I want to measure and see the magnitude of the city, the expanse of the city, the size of the city. And behold, the angel who talked with me went forth. And another angel met with him. So the prophet is busy conversing with an angel. And when he looks again, he sees a young man running with a measuring line. And he says to the young man, where are you going? And he says, I am going to measure Jerusalem. I want to see the sphere of this city. And the angel that was with him, I want you to see the picture. The angel that was with him flies and meets with another angel. And the prophet is beholding. And the Bible says, and the angel that talked with me, he went. And another angel went out to meet him. And he said to the second angel, run. Look at the person next year and say, he said to the second angel, run. You see, when I was looking at this, the Holy Ghost said to me, he just dropped a statement in my heart. He said, when the angels run. When the angels run. Listen. Listen to the magnitude of this thing. Angels are fast already. So in other words, when we say God has dispatched an angel to come to you and do something, the speed with which it travels is fast. Huh? You know the planes we were talking about? They are nothing to the speed of an angel. If God would cut your eyes to see the things in the realm of the spirit, one of these days when you sit in that plane,
Just say, God, show me the angels. Where they are, you will see the angel flying, just easily flying next to the plane. You say to me, when angels run, Kalabosada. You see, when angels run, you're doing good. Continuing gaining mustard. I love Jesus.
Amen.
He is just too much. Huh? He says, run. Speak to this young man. Say, Jerusalem shall be inhabited. A city without walls. Because of the multitude of people and livestock inside Jerusalem, it shall be inhabited. A city without walls. A city without limitations.
Amen.
A city without demarcations.
Amen.
A city without measure.
Amen.
Look at the person next to you and say, Jerusalem,
Jerusalem
shall be inhabited.
Shall be inhabited.
A city,
a city
without walls.
Without walls.
Let me preach to my friends at the back. Look at the person next to you and say, Jerusalem
shall be inhabited.
A city without walls. It's too much anointing. Try it next week. I can actually tell you where it's. I mean it. I don't know why. Because I know it moves like work.
Hallelujah.
I'm not joking.
Amen.
It shall be inhabited. A city without walls. Because of the multitude of people and lives, made their own measurements and expected them to fit me. Those who saw you yesterday have no idea who you are. Analyzed you. Men have measured you. They have decided what you're worth. They don't know you.
Amen.
Your measurement is changing.
Amen.
Albert Einstein once said, everyone is a genius, but if you judge a fish on its ability to climb a tree, that fish will live its whole life behaving and believing that it is stupid. Ladies and gentlemen,
sons and daughters, boys and girls. The season we have entered is a good season. And the title of this message that I have gone around trying to introduce is Dimensions, Levels, and Measurements. You see, that Jerusalem is you. And I want to tell you today that God has a big idea concerning Jerusalem. Look at the person next to you and say, God is a big idea.
God is a big idea.
God's big idea is that you as a city become a city without walls. A city not limited in all its spheres. It is not right that you kept living limited in your financial sphere. It's not right that you kept living limited in the place that you are. It's not right that you are limited socially. It's not right that you are limited financially. It's not right that you are limited in every area of your life. Praise God. Praise God. So is the city that is called you, the city that is called me, God's big idea is that this city must carry a certain capacity. And that capacity cannot be contained within walls. It cannot be contained within a place that is limited. Look at the person next to you and say, take off the walls.
Take off the walls.
Say it with conviction this time, take off the walls.
Take off the walls.
It cannot be inhabited as a city with walls. The reason being, in that city, there must be a multitude of people, and there must be a multitude of life. And when you see the Old Testament speaking livestock, it's speaking prosperity. Today I'm demanding your money back. I'm demanding your cars back. I'm demanding your houses back. I'm demanding the things that the devil has stolen from you. Look at this. This is beautiful. It says, multitude of livestock, meaning your high community. But then it also says, multitude of people. This is speaking of your sphere of influence. Oh, you will not eat with cheap people.
Amen.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
Amen.
You will not fellowship with fools.
Amen.
Clever people are your companion.
Amen.
Men of wisdom, amen, men of power,
amen,
men of mastery,
yes,
are the ones who fellowship with you.
Amen.
It depicts a city prosperous and a city at the top level. Look at the person next to you and say, levels.
Levels.
Say it, levels.
Levels.
Dimensions.
Dimensions.
Measurements. measurements. Look at the person next to you and say levels. A city at the top level. A top-notch city. A city at the top level. Look at the person next to you and say levels. Dimensions. Measurements. Look at the person next to you and say the devil can't measure me. The devil can't level me. The devil can't demarcate me. I belong to the top notch. I am a top class. So when they say to you, how are the levels? You say, top notch. You see, when the word of God arrives, when the word of God comes, when the word of God lands, it comes to break commonality. Amen. It comes to break commonality. Today, I'm here to announce to you that you are not a duplicate. You are not a copy. Who are you? A city that God has defined. A city that God has put together. A city that God has called. So your place is the place that is called here. Perfect man. You can come to that level. You can come into that place. And nobody has any right of classifying you. Look at the person next to you and say, I'm a master. You see, desire must propel you to another level. Begin to desire. Are you hearing me, somebody? Don't fear challenges. Because when challenges come, they are here to take you to another level. You know, when you look at the man of God, Daniel, whenever Daniel went down, he came back for a higher position. So there's a good measure for you. There's a good level for you that God has predetermined in your life. His idea, his agenda was always for you to live a maximum life. Look at the person next to you and say, maximum.
Life.
Say it again, maximum.
Maximum.
Life.
Life.
The devil has no right to limit you on what you eat. Eat my vinya because you want to eat my vinya. Mangai, because you miss them and you just wanna kiss them. And when you come across those who are eating them and they say, please come and eat, you don't go. You don't need to finish your hunger there. Because abundance is in your own heart. You hearing me, somebody? In this season, God will break stagnancy for you. We are tired of you remaining in the same place where you were always. You will dwell as a city without limits. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you're coming from. You might be saying, I'm just a student. I am saying today that they are blessed students in the kingdom of God. The devil is a liar. You cannot be measured. There's some who try to measure your beauty. No. They cannot measure your beauty. There's some who try to measure your money. No. They cannot measure your money. There's some who try to measure your social life. No, they cannot measure it. There's some who try to measure everything about you. I'm here to say to you today that you will dwell as a city without measure. No one can measure you. Just when they think you are about to expire, you begin. You continue. You start. When they think your money has run out, that's when you are beginning to enter another level. Are you hearing me, somebody? Because your own father, Papa God, cannot be measured. The Bible tells us that the elders around the throne, they fall down and worship all the time. Do you know what's going on there? It's because just when they think they have known temple and they have worshipped him, he just reveals another side of himself. And when they see that side, they fall down again and they worship. The disciples did the same thing. Huh? When Jesus calmed the storm, he said, "Hush, peace be still." And there was a stillness. And the disciples said, "What manner of man is this? We have known him opening blind eyes, and we thought it was enough. We have known him raising the cripples. We thought it was enough. We have known him breaking paralysis. We thought it was enough. But this level that he has entered, I prophesy new levels in your life. I prophesy new levels in your life. I prophesy new levels." They could not understand. They said, "What manner of man is this? What type of man is he? Who speaks to stone?" And they hear. You shall not be limited. Those who think they knew your business, they are in for a big surprise. Those customers that thought because they turned you down, then you are down. No, no, no. They are in for a big surprise. That guy that fired you and thought you were going to come back begging, I am here to tell you, I am here to announce to you that he is in for a surprise. Because your God, the giver of levels, is taking you to another dimension. From glory to glory, from measure to measure, from level to level, from dimension to dimension. Look at the person next to you and say, "Give me my levels." There's a turnaround for you. Oh yeah, there's a turnaround for you. There's a turnaround for you. You see, when you understand the significance of this, you will know that even though I am a maid right now, I cannot remain a maid. There's another level. You will know that even though I am a clerk, there's another level. Roboshotoboloto. Every demon that kept you at a lower level is bound today. Karabosatalama. Reboshopata. Roman Sokorobotosa. Mapepepeketoto. Mapuru Nubusatalia. Rasondo Sonorosolo. Those things that kept you 1,000 there are broken today. You, child of God, are moving into higher levels. Come up and feel the winds. Are you hearing me, somebody? Come up and feel the wind of the Holy Ghost. You will not remain there. You will not remain an employee. You will become an employer. You will not remain a cripple. You will walk again. You will dance again. You will jump again. Higher dimensions. Higher levels. Higher measurements. That's where you belong. That's where I belong. From glory to glory. Yeah. tithe. I am declaring today that you will tithe being driven. Not driven in a taxi, but in your own car. If your father died a teacher, you are going to a higher level. You are holding a school. If your father died a university lecturer, there is a level called holding a university. And you should be this shepherd. The devil is a liar. I say the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Be seated, you're clapping, my son. I say the devil is a liar. Look at the person next to you and say dimensions. Levels. Measurements. Now you know your measure is determined by God. Amen. Men can't measure me. But men spoke well. He said the only man who behaved sensibly was my tailor. Every time he saw me, he measured me again. Because he knew there was room for expansion. There was room for expansion. Everything that is meant by the will of God grows. That's why, if you visit a small tree that you planted 5 years ago and you never went back, if you went back today, you are in for a surprise. Because that baby tree expanded. If you never thought, and you said, let me build it close to the house, you will be surprised that you might have to cut it down, because now this little tree that you thought was just a seed expanded. The root system expanded, and now it has become a threat to your own house. It is the desire of God that you as his child expand. He wants your levels to go higher. He wants your money to expand. You will see all these things. See all these things, because this is a series. But in gaining mastery life, we're gonna go big on it. We're gonna go big on it. And then afterwards, we come back, we continue small on it. You get what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying? Look at the person next to you and say, my levels. Say it again, my levels. Say it again, my levels. I will teach you how to put up your levels. In fact, the best way is how to upload your levels. The IT people will understand it.
Uploading. How do I upload my levels?
Big contracts are coming to your business. We are lifting your levels. We are lifting your dimensions. You, child of God, cannot be measured. We are lifting the level of your business. We are lifting the level of your life. The Holy Spirit is saying, come to me, come to my level. You see, when you plug into the Holy Ghost, it's like the wind. There is no struggle in him. There is no struggle. There is no sweat in him. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. For his divine power has given unto you all things that pertain to life and unto all godliness. You are a partaker of his divine nature. Partakers. Participants. You participate in the divine nature. Lift your hands where you are. Get ready for a move of the Holy Ghost. Where you are, sit right now.
Let your levels increase. Go to another dimension. In Jesus' name.